Hello, my dear students. Last class I explained about Newmark's influence charts. Today let us discuss about Westergaard's analysis. Poussinesq analysis is applicable to homogeneous soil deposits. In sedimentary soil deposits, we commonly come across clay strata reinforced with lenses of coarse material between them. The problem of finding stresses in such soil deposits due to surface eroding was solved by Westergaard. Westergaard in 1938 also solved the problem of pressure distribution in soil under point load by assuming some of the points like the soil mass is an elastic medium. The modulus of elasticity, that is E or Young's modulus of soil, is constant. The soil mass is semi-infinite in extent, that means it is bound by the ground surface and extends infinitely in all other directions. And also he assumed that the soil mass is to be laterally reinforced by numerous closely spaced horizontal sheets of negligible thickness of an infinitely rigid material, which prevent the mass as a whole from undergoing any lateral strain. These are some of the assumptions of Westergaard's. Now let us see what is his theory. Let us consider the Westergaard equation for vertical stress at a point P located at depth Z below the surface. Let us assume, okay, this is just assume, there is a point P which is located at a depth Z below the surface and at radial distance R from the axis of loading. Due to point load Q acting on the surface, it is given by, this is the formula, I am not shown any derivation, directly I have taken the equation formula, sigma Z vertical stress is equal to QZ divided by 2 pi into R cube. So again you can elaborate it and write Q divided by 2 pi mu square Z square into 1 plus R divided by mu Z whole square to the power 3 by 2, where Z is equal to, the depth is equal to mu into Z, and mu is equal to square root of 1 minus 2 mu divided by 2 into 1 minus mu. The value of mu varies from 0 to 0.5 for elastic materials. For a case of large lateral restraint, the lateral strain is very small and mu may be assumed as 0. Okay, so this is the equation you have to remember to find the vertical stress using Westergaard analysis. Here nu is given by this equation, where mu is equal to value, if it is not given you can take it from 0 to 0.5 for elastic materials, but when it is a case of large restraint, then it can be considered as 0. So then again you can reduce this equation, so it becomes sigma Z is equal to Q divided by Z square into this pi into 1 plus 2 into R divided by Z whole square to the power 3 by 2. So where you can write in terms of influence factor also Kw. This Kw is called as Westergaard influence factor. How in the Poussinesq equation we considered Kb, like that here Westergaard influence factor is Kw. So vertical stress sigma Z is equal to Kw into Q divided by Z square, where Kw is equal to Westergaard's influence factor, that is equal to 1 divided by pi into 1 plus 2 into R divided by Z whole square to the power 3 by 2. Value of Kw as a function of R by Z are given in the table. Similarly, like Poussinesq equation where it was Kb and the ratio also R divided by Z, we used to find using the table. The table is given here. Westergaard's influence factor for vertical pressure caused by a surface point load. This ratio, if you have R and Z value, you can find what is Kw. Okay, so the different values of R divided by Z ratio is given here, 0, 0.02, 0.04, 0.06, like that, 0.44, everything. For for that particular ratio, what is Kw, Westergaard's influence factor. So here you can find all these values. Okay, so till 0 to 0.42 is there, 0.44 to 0.86, 0.8 to 1.3, 1.3 to 1.74, 1.76 to 3. So okay, so 0 to 3 values we have Westergaard's influence factor values can find using this table. Now let us see for the what is the formula for a uniformly loaded circular area. The vertical pressure under the center of circular load of intensity Q and radius A is given by this equation. Okay, how the Business equation, there also there was a formula for uniformly loaded circular area, but that formula is slightly different than this. Okay, so here using Westergaard analysis for the uniformly loaded circular area, you can find vertical pressure using this formula, that is sigma z is equal to q into 1 minus into bracket 1 divided by 1 plus a divided by nu z square to whole to the power half. Okay, this is the formula to find the vertical stress under uniformly loaded circular area. The following table gives the data for influence chart with the influence value of 0.001 and modified depth. Okay, you can see here this is a table which also gives the value based on Westergaard analysis. Suppose this is the circle number 1 to 20. Okay, the radius for suppose circle 1 radius is 0.64, so radial division is 45. Like that for the different circle number, the radius is given and here radial division also given. Okay, this is table is related to if that mu z is equal, nu z is equal to 5 centimeter and influence value is 0.001. The method of using the chart is the same as the Newmark's chart, except that the scale for plotting the loaded area is obtained by equating the modified depth mu z of a given problem to 5 centimeter of the chart, where mu is equal to 0 and nu is equal to 0.707. okay, let us see for the rectangular area under the Westergaard's analysis. So sigma z at the corner of the rectangular area with the sides mz and nz is given by this formula. Okay, formula for finding the vertical stress under uniformly loaded rectangular area in case of Business equation. Now this is Westergaard equation, so slight difference there is. Sigma z is equal to q divided by 2 pi into cot inverse of square root of 1 minus 2 mu divided by 2 minus 2 mu into 1 divided by m square plus 1 divided by n square plus 1 minus 2 mu divided by 2 minus 2 mu whole square into 1 divided by m square n square. This is the formula to find vertical stress under uniformly loaded rectangular area. Suppose if mu is equal to 0, okay, then this equation becomes like this, that is sigma z mu equal to 0. So this equation q divided by 2 pi into cot inverse of this term becomes 0. So only 1 is there here, 1 divided by 2. So when you simplify this, you get this equation, q divided by 2 pi into cot inverse of square root of 1 divided by 2 m square plus 1 divided by 2 n square plus 1 divided by 4 m square n square. Now, see, this is the comparison between Business equation and Westergaard solution. For a point load, we have sigma z, that is equal to k into q divided by z square. This is the common equation. If it is the Business equation, you have to consider this as kb. If it is a Westergaard analysis, then it is kw. Other things are same. Only this is the difference to find the vertical stress stress under the point load. Okay, so Kb is equal to 3 divided by 2 pi A, divided by 1 plus R divided by Z whole square to the power 5 by 2. This you know, for Boussinesq analysis already we have solved some examples. Now for the Westergaard analysis, K is equal to Kw and is given by this formula, 1 divided by pi into 1 plus 2 into R divided by Z whole square to the power 3 by 2. Okay, so let us see some comparison between Boussinesq and Westergaard's theories. In figure, the stress distribution on horizontal planes are shown at two depths. Okay, here you can see this depth 0 to 2 and this side also 0 to 2 and load is acting here. Boussinesq analysis and Westergaard analysis are shown in this figure for the two depths. Okay, in practice, Boussinesq analysis is widely used as it gives conservative values. Boussinesq equation is commonly used as compared to Westergaard's theory. It is clear from the size of the curves. You can see here, this curve is related to Boussinesq equation and this down curve is related to Westergaard analysis. So, Boussinesq analysis gives greater stress than Westergaard analysis, with the difference decreasing with increasing R by Z ratio and also increasing depth. This is for the depth Z is equal to 1 and this is with the Z is equal to 2. And here also the top curve is related to Boussinesq equation and the bottom curve is related to Westergaard equation. So what we can say is Boussinesq analysis gives greater stress compared to Westergaard analysis, with the difference decreasing with the increasing R by Z ratio and also increasing depth. However, homogeneous soil deposits of large depth are near to assumptions made in Boussinesq analysis, and sedimentary deposits or stratified soil deposits are approximately nearer to assumptions made in Westergaard analysis. Here you can see this curve is just shown in this. This is Boussinesq curve and this is Westergaard's curve. Okay, a variation of Kb and Kw with R by Z ratio. This is the K values and this x-axis is R by Z ratio. Boussinesq equation assumes isotropy condition, but Westergaard equation assumes stratified soil condition. Okay, Boussinesq considered only for isotropic soil, but here Westergaard consider stratified soil condition also. Hence, Westergaard's equation is closer to field conditions in sedimentary deposits. However, engineers prefer Boussinesq equation to compute stresses, since settlements computed from these stresses give conservative values. Although the Westergaard equation that is very close to field conditions in stratified or sedimentary deposit, engineers usually prefer Boussinesq equation to compute the vertical stress. This is the table which shows the value of Kb and Kw for different R by Z ratio. Okay, for 0 R by Z ratio, Kb is 0.4775 and Kw is 0.3183. Similarly, for 0.2, 0.4329, 0.2836. Like that, for 3, it is 0.0014 and 0.0038 for Westergaard analysis. And here also you can see from the table as well as the figure. Now I have shown this table and this figure. So based on this, we can clearly say that Kw is smaller than Kb for R by Z ratio is less than 1.52 and is greater than Kb for R by Z ratio is greater than 1.52 approximately. This fact is also reflected in the comparison of vertical stress distribution on horizontal plane at specified depth from both the solutions. Okay, so this is Boussinesq solution, this is Westergaard analysis. So you can see here, till this 1.52, the Boussinesq equation has higher value compared to Westergaard. But after this 1.52, Westergaard analysis takes higher value than the Boussinesq equation. Okay, I hope all of you understood. Thank you.